Hi, my name is Robin and I'm one of the talking heads behind NZ Pocket Guide, New Zealand's largest travel guide. Over the past 10 years in New Zealand, I've done well over 600 activities, so many so that I stopped counting. In fact, you can see my partner Laura and I doing well over 400 activities on this YouTube channel alone. But now it's time to sort through all of them and rank my top 101 best activities in New Zealand. Today, we'll cover number 90 to 81. There will be some free ones, there will be some paid ones, and there will be some which are suggested by you. So get busy in the comments telling me your favorite and let's get started. At number 90, we have landing on the Tasman Glacier by ski plane. The Tasman Glacier is New Zealand's longest glacier and trust me, it's gonna make another appearance on this list. And once you land on top of the glacier, you'll be able to gaze at New Zealand's tallest mountain, Mount Cook. It's a day out like no other. At number 89, we have the Rere Rock Slide near Gisborne. Forget all the water parks, New Zealand has natural water parks like the Rere Rock Slide. It's a beautifully smooth rocks with a waterfall on top of it. Just grab your inflatable mattress and slide down the slopes. Number 88 on the list is rail biking in the Forgotten World. You can get real sweaty doing that if you choose the pedal-powered rail bike. You can see us right here, we've got a massive sweat. Now you can also choose an electric one if you want to take it easy breezy, and basically you're gonna make your way through a disused railway in one of the most remote places in New Zealand. At number 87 we have Washburn Falls. This one takes my heart. You never think that in the Canterbury Plains you can find such amazing hidden gems, but the Washburn Falls is a bird paradise. It has Maori history, it has a volcanic landscape, and it even has a little pond where you can row a boat. Plus on top of that you can stand on the cliff and get amazing picture of the whole Canterbury Plains. It's a must do. Number 86 is brought to you by a massive earthquake, and no, I am not talking about Christchurch. In 1931, the city of Napier was devastated by a massive fire that was caused by a massive earthquake, and they had to rebuild the whole town, and they decided to do so in an Art Deco style. Well, you can do a tour and check out the massive amount of stunning architecture around the city. Number 85 is visiting the Bridge to Nowhere. Once upon a time, farmers wanted to settle in the Whanganui National Park and wanted to graze all their cattle around there. And to do so, they had to make their way through it. So they had to build a bridge, but then it was abandoned and there is just a bridge standing in the middle of the forest. It is quite the sight. So when I did number 84, I didn't think about bringing a camera. I was young and I was stupid. Now it's Baldwin Street. It is for the young and stupid. What is it? It's just a very steep street. In fact, it's one of the steepest streets in the world. Sometimes it is the steepest street in the world, sometimes it's not. But look at those people over there. They look super happy. Look at them smiling and be happy standing on a very steep street. Anyway, it is kind of interesting to see how steep it is, actually, for real. Like, I mean, check it out. At number 83 we have the Moeraki boulders. Those perfectly spherical stones standing on the beach make the perfect picture opportunity on a road trip on the South Island of New Zealand. So make sure to check it out. Plus it's not too far from Baldwin Street, which is in Dunedin, which I just talked about. So once you checked out that street, stay in the car and keep on driving to Moeraki. At number 82, we're sticking with free attractions to visit and we are looking at the Whangarei Falls. They are probably one of the easiest waterfall to access in the entire country, right about maybe 5 minutes walk from the city center of Whangarei. It is amazing, there is a big canyon, there is a bridge to pass above the falls, it just looks fantastic. And if you know how to do slow shutter pictures, you'll get some smooth waterfall pictures that everybody loves. At number 81 we have the Omaka Aviation Heritage Center, yes that's the full name of it. Okay, so it's a collection of airplanes from World War I, World War II, and they're all put into scenes designed by the Weta Studio. It all looks absolutely fantastic, and it's basically if your museum was brought to life. It's really cool to visit. Alright, that's it for me today. Do you guys agree with my picks? There is a link right above my head to the full article on NZ Pocket Guide with more information about each of the activities that I just mentioned today if you want to know more. Just a quick reminder that everybody is a winner here. With all the activities that I was lucky enough to do around New Zealand, making it to the top 101 is quite amazing, no matter the placement. Remember to hit me up in the comments below with your favorite things to do in New Zealand so I can mention you by name in an upcoming videos where I'll be covering your guys' suggestions. Hit like and subscribe to get notified when that video comes out, and have fun exploring New Zealand.